So John, tell us a little bit how you discovered D'Angelico. You were in New York City, but how did you find out about the guitars? When did you get your first D'Angelico?
Well, 100 years ago, I was just a kid then. But actually, the first time I heard about a D'Angelico was my father's buddy. My dad was a mailman, but he played guitar. And he had a guy that had a D'Angelico. This was, I must have been 12 or 13 years old, so figure like mid-40s. And I'll never forget when I first picked that guitar up, it just knocked me back, you know, the sound of it was so gorgeous. I always wanted one, and later on, I 53, he built me one.
Nice.
And that's the beginning, you know. Now, Ron, you want to talk a little about anything about the when we, how you found out about the
guitar? Well, basically, there was our friend of yours and a very old friend of mine from my hometown in Pittsburgh, Joe Negri.
Oh.
And he had a D'Angelico. He was on Mr. Rogers' show, Handyman Negri. I'm sure many of you saw that show. And he had a D'Angelico, and I, you know, saw the guitar and fell in love with it. I think I had an Epiphone or something at the time. My guitar was okay, but not like the D'Angelico. So I did go to New York, and I told John, I said, you know, I don't have a lot of money, I said, but I got to get one of your guitars, because it's the best guitar there is. And at that time, I think the price was $450 or something.
That's a bargain.
Yeah.
They were really expensive.
But that was a lot of money in those days. That was 1959, I think.
Yeah.
But anyway, I said, well, I got to have one. That's all there is to it. So I don't know what I did. I borrowed the money or got my dad to take a loan or something. And I did get the guitar, and it's still the same guitar.
Yeah.
I've had it, you know, ever since I was a kid, you know. That's just about 5 years ago. And, anyway, I love the guitar, and John was such a beautiful, beautiful person. A very sweet guy, and I used to go and visit him, you know, even when I wasn't, you know, doing anything, and just hang out with him. And then, of course, to meet Jim DeCristo, I got to know him pretty well, too. So, but anyway, great. I will never be able to thank him enough for this guitar that's given me so much pleasure and giving me the opportunity to travel all over the world with lots of great people. Thank you very much.
One day, Samba.
Let's start.